Allen, his three-pointer, bang! Tie game with 5 seconds remaining! The Yankees are champions of baseball!
Haven, Connecticut, famously known as the home of Yale University, Lighthouse Point Park, the Italians and Worcester Street, and of course, the best pizza in the country. Little do people know, New Haven is also the birthplace of America's hard-hitting obsession, football.
I know you can't cover, you too pretty. Right there, number two, you too pretty.
Way back in 1876, a young man by the name of Walter Camp roamed the halls of Yale, eager to join the newly introduced football team, which was more like rugby at the time. Despite being elected as captain and only losing one game over his 4 years as a player, Camp felt unsettled with the rules and the overall style of play. With his unique and transformative ideas, Camp changed the game into the organized and exhilarating one we rave about today. 11 men per side, the line of scrimmage, line markers, and the 6, 3, 2, and 1 scoring system are few of many contributions Camp made to football. He is also responsible for selecting the very first All-American team in 1889, a prestigious honor college football still celebrates today. But maybe the most important thing Camp left behind is the preaching of football being family. His legacy still lives through the Walter Camp Football Foundation. This all-volunteer organization was founded in 1967 and has welcomed legends of the game from multiple generations. The city of New Haven plays host to this event every January, where members of the Walter Camp family partake in an action-packed weekend. Tony Mortali and his son Mike are two of many Walter Camp officials who steer the ship for this highly anticipated weekend full of fun and excitement. I had the chance to sit down with them and discuss why the best of the best continue to show unconditional love and support for this city and its people. 51 years of the Walter Camp Foundation. What does this event mean to the city of New Haven?
It's great for the community. We've always tried to promote it for the youth, the city youth of New Haven. It's a great learning tool for them. Just to show them what you can do if you excel yourself in the classroom and on the football field. Basically, no matter where you come from, whatever walks of life you come from, there's an opportunity to be the best that you can possibly be.
Mike has been a part of the Walter Camp phenomenon since he was a little kid. Now, he's responsible for hosting student athletes throughout the weekend. Over the years, Mike has seen firsthand the connections these players have shared with New Haven's youth and aspiring college football stars.
You know, I think it's still going to be very impactful for the youth organizations and the cities of New Haven and in Connecticut. Definitely for the high school kids that follow Walter Camp, being an all-state player and coming to the dinner has a very impactful meaning to those kids. It's definitely going to continue to grow and be a great, successful weekend, as long as it's going to be around.
Walter Camp Weekend officially kicks off here at the Floyd Little Center in New Haven, Connecticut, where the college football family gathers as one for this event. Alumni and current Walter Camp All-Americans strive to motivate the community and to simply give back.
You guys right now are at the crossroads and you're setting the path and the tone for your life. You understand? I have regrets and I wish I would have paid attention and was more serious about education when I was coming up. You guys have an opportunity to do that.
Former University of Georgia and Chicago Bears running back Tim Worley wowed the crowd with his words of encouragement at the Stay in School rally in 2014, setting the bar for future years to come. This type of motivation inspires the youth to thrive not only in the classroom, but to mature as successful people. Walter Camp alumni stick to a similar agenda every year. They spend Friday morning visiting children and veterans hospitals to lighten the spirits of patients and their families. Their devotion and kind-hearted community service is what drives the Walter Camp family to never stop giving back, which President Michael Madera says is the primary focus of the foundation.
Walter Camp Football Foundation just isn't about football. It's about giving back. It's about honoring people. It's about making monetary donations to charity. It's about getting the word out there on doing the right thing and what it means to be a good person in society and constantly giving back. You know, there are people less fortunate that are not here today or aren't at some of these events. And you know, and our foundation does a tremendous job of supporting all those charities.
The emphasis of giving back has Walter Camp alumni itching to come back to New Haven for this eventful weekend. In fact, the president of Walter Camp alumni and former NFL linebacker David Fulcher has this weekend printed in ink every year.
New Haven is unbelievable. I mean, I know it's cold and sometimes it's some bad weather. My wife Judy, we actually have it on our calendar for the next 20 years because we live for this day.
The highlight of the weekend, however, is the All-American Youth Clinic. Countless autographs, professional insight, and fundamental drills has the gymnasium buzzing from start to finish. It's safe to say everyone, well, has a little bit of fun.
Expected it to be like this. I swear every day we lit.
Yeah, every day we lit. Yeah. You can't tell me. Yeah. Remember I was broke. Yeah. Now I'm getting rich.
We're the linemen.
This Walter Camp roster speaks for itself. Future NFL Hall of Famer and the 2018 Walter Camp Man of the Year winner, Calvin Johnson, participated in this event in 2006 as an All-American and the top college prospect from Georgia Tech. Johnson admits, being back in New Haven feels all too familiar.
Oh man, it's nostalgia being here. You know, when I walked into this building, I kind of remember like 12 years ago, whenever it was I was here last, you know. So being able to come out, give back to the community, you know, it's in my DNA. You know, I do it with my foundation. I understand how important it is to go back and give to those that, you know, whether they're less fortunate or not, just being a role model for the kids, that's all that matters.
The term role model came up numerous times when talking to current and former players throughout the weekend. Lukas, Denis of Boston College and Syracuse's Ervin Phillips, who grew up in West Haven just miles up the road, described their Walter Camp weekend experiences as surreal. They reflected back on when they were kids and viewed All-Americans as people to look up to. Now, they are those people and role models as well.
I just always think back to when I was a kid and I always had somebody to tell me like what to do, what not to do, right from wrong. So I feel like just coming in and being able to talk to the kids early at a young age, it's just, you can help put them on the right track, you know, keep a lot of kids out of trouble, keep a lot of kids with the right mindset. I think that they really got to be able to believe that they can accomplish everything that they want to accomplish.
It's an honor, man. I always want to try to inspire the community where I came from, you know. Coming up, you know, you need a role model. Kids need somebody to look up to and want to try to be like, you know. And to be in that position, it's an honor because you feel like you're just playing football, but these kids are looking at you like, yo, you're doing something that's really special. Really, you're just playing a game, you know. And I take that very strongly, and I try to use it to the best of my ability to try to hopefully make the next kid who wants to come up and do the same thing I'm doing want to chase his dreams just like I did.
The genuine excitement and countless interactions the players and fans have throughout the event is infectious, something Fulcher can't seem to get enough of.
The one thing that I can hold on to, man, is I know that the Walter Camp Football Foundation is a family, and it's given families an opportunity to reach out to each other. And with the football players being here and speaking to the kids, it makes everything the way it should be.
One player who headlined the weekend grabbed the most attention and may have had the best time of all the college athletes, Baker Mayfield. Fresh off a Heisman-winning season, the Oklahoma star had the chance to spend time with some of his biggest fans in a city, he says, is unlike any other.
It's awesome, you know, to be here in itself is great, but then, you know, putting a smile on kids' faces, it means so much more. It's so much bigger than a game. To be able to inspire kids to chase their dreams, that means a lot to me.
Mayfield will also take home some hardware at the conclusion of one of New Haven's finest gatherings, as he was selected as the Walter Camp Player of the Year. This accolade, the future NFL quarterback says, goes beyond his on-field numbers. Instead, it revolves around tradition and camp's overall contributions to the game we know today.
No, it's definitely up there because you think about what it stands for, how much he impacted the game of college football. It wouldn't have been the same without him. So it's definitely at the top of my list.
Mayfield will be accepting this award under a different set of Saturday night lights, not the ones that illuminate the gridiron and 90,000 screaming fans. He'll share the lights here with his brothers and sisters of the Walter Camp family. The annual and traditional Walter Camp weekend wraps up with its ceremonial dinner where all the stars show up dressed to the nines and shine through the night. Players are recognized for their accomplishments on and off the field, but one All-American I spoke to summed up this luxurious night in just one word: showtime.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a vibe, she wanna vibe, that's a vibe, yeah, that's a vibe, it's a vibe, and that's a vibe, yeah, that's a vibe, oh, it's a vibe.
The red carpet seems to fit for this assembly of former, current, and future stars of the game. The All-Americans are thrilled to accept their awards on this night while being accompanied by those who paved the way before them. One of those predecessors happens to be a premier face of college football. Winner of the 2018 Distinguished American Award is Lee Corso, who is beyond ecstatic to be a part of this banquet that is truly one of a kind.
This is a thrill of a lifetime because it's such a legendary award, and the people here are just great, and everything about it is first class, no question about that. Being a part of the tradition and is a part of football. This Walter Camp thing is special. As long as it's going on, 51 years this banquet is going on.
Walter Camp Weekend honors tradition. It recognizes the game's greats and authors the story of these athletes who impact lives in positive ways. It also spotlights the journeys of true heroes. Heroes don't have to wear capes or helmets. Heroes are courageous, strong-willed, and driven to impact the lives of many, or maybe just one. This year's Walter Camp American Hero is only 12 years old. Noah Aldrich is a young boy from Boise, Idaho, who competes in rigorous triathlons, knowing every time he's not going to win. Along for the swims, bike rides, and runs is Noah's little brother, Lukas. Lukas was born with a severe disability known as lissencephaly. He can't walk or talk, and doctors say this brain malformation is expected to end his life before the age of 10. Lukas has a weakened immune system, and the Aldrich family were advised to either keep Lukas away from the outside world or allow him to live his life. This decision was easy. Whenever Noah competes, Lukas is right behind him. And frankly, that's all he needs.
It can be hard, but I just look back and see Lukas's smile, and it just kind of fuels me up to keep going. As long as Lukas is having fun, I'm having fun, and I don't care if we come in first or second or any place at all. As long as we finish the race and we're both happy.
Noah and Lukas' story of brotherhood and love stole the show on this special night. Before Corso accepted his award, he took a moment to commend them, saying this is what Walter Camp Weekend is all about.
Noah, you are a true Walter Camp hero. The luckiest person in the room is Lukas. To have you as a brother.
Life is not measured by the amount of breaths we take, but by the moments that take our breath away. Moments frozen in time. A hero, his wingman, and new members welcomed to the Walter Camp family now and forever in the city of New Haven.
Wait for me to come home. Is there any problems? Any bottles? Any models? But like this, like gobble, talking gobble, keep standing, and they feel it.
22 tricks on me, 22 clothes on me, 22 goals on me.
Viagra.
You got to sweat right now, man. How does it feel, dude?
Man, it's because of these little guys, like all these guys chasing me.
Dude, how does it feel to be a part of this event, just to give back to the community in the way you
are? It's just humbling, and it's an honor to be here. So anything I can do, y'all sign your shirt, no problem. See, guys like him, that's why I'm here. So.
Country Thomas might barely a promise. Okay, he said he never let a divide their commas. Facts before they got rich, they was some road runners. Putting piping like a fool plumber. They thinking stupid, I'ma act dumber. The whip see more donuts than a nigga Homer. Ay, drop her off at Phillips, tell her take a trip. Then I take her back home and on her lips. Any problems? Any bottles? Any models, but like this, like gobble, keep standing, pew, pew, and they feel it.
Yeah. 22 tricks on me, 22 clothes on me, 22 goals on me, 22 bros on me. Giving you sweat for free, learn how to dress for me, keeping it beneath.
One more time,
chilling.
Okay, get my.